Welcome to From the Left with Stephen Leon. And tonight's show is going to be about the present state of affairs. I took a couple of months off to focus on getting signatures for ballot access. Shout out to the GCD Network for hosting the show. And, you know, I wanted, since we just, I hope everyone had a good fourth. It means a lot to me, celebrating the fourth, running for Congress, the House of Representatives, as an independent that leans left, because George Washington himself was from Mount Vernon, and he was an independent again, and he warned very sternly about how parties could just unravel what we really want. And, you know, that's just the thing about democracies. And that's not to say that all parties are always, they can serve popular ends. And this is verbatim, or in effect from what he's quoted, on how parties can do that. They can narrate ideas, and disillusionment can happen. One of the big things that I found a good compromising balance between the parties is, let's rescind these bans that we're talking about when it comes to firearms and abortions, right? When you know that most firearm related murders are from red states, right? And then you've just got the left saying, let's ban it, right? But then you've got the right over here saying, let's ban abortion rights, you know what I mean? To some degree. And it's just stalemating like that. And those narratives are not constitutional, right? What are you going to do with, if you were to ever pass an assault weapons ban, are you going to confiscate people's assault weapons? Where do you draw the line with that stuff? And the same thing goes with abortion rights. You're not going to get the left to get rid of their abortion rights. They want their rights to that, no matter what it is. It's just Amendment 1 being a partial to that. Anyways, so, you know, I really wanted to open up this. I wanted to open this up with playing a song. I know. Yeah, I did. But I don't know if you guys can hear this. Can you guys hear this? I don't even know. This mic that I have, it isolates. It's like a blue mic. And, you know, I usually don't play that often for public said his show's not about that at all. You know what? I'm not gonna play. I'm not feeling it right now. You guys are gonna have to wait for that. It was research. You know, can you even hear this? I don't even know. It doesn't. If you guys can't hear that, I'm not even gonna attempt. I'm not Bill Clinton. I'm not coming out of some kind of, you know, thing from the ground on Arsenio Hall. So I was going to play a bar from the Star Spangled Banner, but again, I'm not feeling right now. So, present state of affairs. Let's start off with, again, you know, I was taking a couple of months off to get signatures. It's grueling, you know what I mean? I'm not coming from a party, so it wasn't just very easy for me to, especially for an incumbent, to just go in there and get signatures or whatever it was, you know what I mean? So I was able to hire some people. Some people were good, some people weren't so much. You know, it's just what it's like managing people, you know. And so I submitted 1,086. The minimum requirement is 1,000. And then 80 more from a guy that ended up quitting on me before we can get them notarized. I wrote a nice letter. You know, there's an appeal process if I don't make that. So there's always the write-in option. And then also maybe working with the other independent candidates and combining our platforms, and we would just be unbeatable. You know what I mean? Most of us that are running for, as independents, do lean left. So that's really cool to combine those ideas, especially with the Digital Democracy Project that I've been putting out there, and how that speaks directly to a constituency or the people. And again, I said that, I don't really like that word, constituents. So and especially here in Virginia's 8th District, with how educated we are, and even not so much, it's just the knowledge that we have, you know what I mean, these days with the internet, and if you're using credible sources and you get it and you're able to communicate it, rather than appeasing some lobby or PAC group. Again, those PACs are going to give you money. It's that's the perfect thing when it comes to, you know, firearms amendment 2 and abortion amendment 1. And, you know, they just give you money because you go along, and it's stalemating. And hopefully, maybe even what I'm doing right now, if I make it, we'll set an example. Like, if the parties ever get to this place again, and an independent can stand up when they're doing it for the right reasons and they've got the right plan, then they would do that. So help balancing out. You're never going to get rid of parties. You're just never going to do it, even if you were to have the sorry, my cat's distracting me. He likes the noisy room. So even if you were to, people are still going to group together. They're still going to group together and form, you know, a group. You know what I mean? They've done experiments with gorillas, and they've seen what they do and just how we're not apes. You know what I mean? But it's a good example. We're not completely apes. So to do that and just to see on how it's to maintain the parties, but bring them together with ideas and compromise. You know what I mean? What's when you have that information with those two examples that I just mentioned with firearms and abortion, like what's the compromise? Why can't you? Cause you don't want to compromise. Like you do that everywhere you go. You know what I mean? Just, and it's based off the data and facts. And I was talking to my partner about this over the weekend, and she's probably watching right now. And she was like, just like her positions of it. And I kept talking and talking and talking, but she's like, okay, fine. If you just shut up. So, hey, there you go. Just filibuster that. Just keep talking and talking and talking. And that's the idea. It's like whoever wants to, that's what we have in America. It's like who's going to be able to speak up for those rights and those collective interests or whatever, and just be able to get it through peaceably. That's what we want. So, yeah. So really, that's social media. I've got a social media game. You know what I mean? People come at me most times than not with some hateful stuff, you know what I mean? Or just they don't understand, or they don't try it. I'm trying to break a mold with it, and I'm going to be blunt. You know what I mean? It's just, I like to call, there's this thing that I picked up out there. It's the anonymous rule 62. Google that, what it means. I mean, don't take yourself so seriously. You know what I mean? Don't do that. And there's certain things, sure, that we do take ourselves seriously for, but especially social media, you know, that's another thing. I know there's, I don't know what it's like to be in Gen Z or even younger than that, to grow up with social media and to be, I don't know what it's like to be a child. And like, I grew up in fifth, sixth grade telling your mama jokes. Sometimes you're the bully. Sometimes someone else is bullying you, or you stop that. You grow up, you grow out of it. You know what I mean? But the way things are today, and I mean, there was a lot of PC language growing up and things like that. You know what I mean? I remember when Michael Jackson put out that Black and White music video. The next day at school, they made like an announcement. Hey, violence. We're like, all of us were like, it's just a music video. We get it. You know what I mean? Like, I grew up, that was at Westgate Elementary. And I think the mailing address we had was McLean. I think it was McLean. Right there on top of McGarity Road. And just on the other side of 495 where Tyson's Corner Mall is. And like, that's just the way it was. You know what I mean? Like, we had fun. We grew up on Nintendo and Sega. And anyway, so I wonder if kids these days are just being crystallized to these things of where you just can't debate or talk or just be kids, you know? And where the only outlet you may have is like through social media, if you're allowed to, if your parents allow you to, you know, there's a minimum age requirement, all of them 13, where they're just, you know, the only place to do that is on social media. And then it gets crystallized in those natural competitive ways that we're doing. It's like with those your mama jokes, it was always about, it wasn't literally about your mother, you know what I mean? It was always who could say it most witty without breaking up whatever it was they were saying, and just like you can carry it a certain way, you know what I mean? And looking back, it was just married with children, you know what I mean? And I get it, we want to find the balance, but I imagine that's for kids to be stuck into some whatever it was in school, or they're teasing you, or whatever, you know, subtle metaphor, analogy, whatever it is, and then just having that crystallized in a venue like social media. Things change, people to have something natural. Again, like if it's bullying or just something you said that was just not cool or just inappropriate, whatever it was growing up, and then the next day you go to school and you just work, you go to school, you know what I mean, and then you deal with it just like everybody else, and you change. Breakfast Club is a really cool video. I hope everyone should see that movie. Like that, it's so well done, and they get these kids into Saturday in school suspension. No, it's not in school suspension. After school detention. Saturday detention on a Saturday, and you get them together, and you see all their difference and all the clicks that they come from, and how they were able to unite. It was really well made. It's probably one of the best. And I've never seen a movie like that. I don't know if they've remade it or not either. So, anyhow, it was really cool getting to farmers markets, knocking on people's doors, explaining my platform. You know, 1 in 5 people are going to say yes. You know, people, I think that. One of my favorite responses was people saying how they believe anyone who wants to be on the ballot should be on the ballot. So just sign that right away. Sometimes I don't really know when somebody wants a big sell on my platform. I may only have 20, 30 seconds or a minute or two to talk to you about it. Sometimes 5, 10 minutes. Some people, those afforded people, the 4 to 5 people that don't sign are, who knows? You know what I mean? Just don't take it personally. You know what I mean? And it could be any reason. They may not know you. Do you really know the incumbent? I can go on and on and on and on about the incumbent. So or just anyone, just by knowing what it is that's the problem, if it's money or things that they've said or done and been contradictory or whatever it is. Especially this incumbent. Well, he's the only pro is that he's nice, but all the cons, I could go on and on about that. This show is about, I'm going to go a little bit higher to the top with present state of affairs, as I've named this show. So going door to door, more people are likely to say yes. It's like a 3-to-1 ratio, maybe not so much in North Arlington. I canvassed out there for one Saturday towards the end there, towards near the June 18th deadline to submit these to Richmond. And just the responses that I would get, it'd be like, I appreciate what you're doing, but I'm not signing your ballot. It's like, or your petition. It's like, okay. Farmers markets. And then for some reason, hey, I got so many more people in South Arlington. I guess people, and this is just one moment. I didn't continue to go up into North Arlington. Maybe there's something about North Arlington around here where people just kind of get stuck in their ways. And if they don't see it on television or whatever it might be, then they don't trust her or whatever. But again, do you really know your incumbent? Do you really know your incumbent? Are they really, at least these days, getting money out of politics? So that's going to jump me up forward to the next thing of the presidential debates. Oh my gosh, here we go. The presidential debate. So we've got two more senior candidates here. One of them has a track record, Donald Trump, of being super unconstitutional with J6 right away. You know, that's exactly what he did. He tried to, that he got popular by creating disillusionment in the media. That's why I advocate for media literacy and the media bias chart by Infamous Media. I freely promote that. And just to see wherever, it's not just real and fake news. It's not just black and white news. And even then, you know what I mean? Like a guy like me comes around and I'm like, I haven't really gotten so much mainstream media attention that I've liked. And I wonder, I don't want to get cynical too much, even though that's a lot of fun. I don't, in therapeutic, I don't, easy, Bruce. Easy, dude. Take it. So, knocked over the chair. So with a guy like me wants to get money out of politics, and not just saying that, it's not just a bullet point. Guy like Rokana says that on his website. You click on the little button and he's got it, and it goes blank. I'm bringing the American Anti-Corruption Act, which has been around for 13 years. So it was really fun to talk about that. It was really easy getting signatures and be like, money out of politics. So yeah, sure, you can see Jennifer Lawrence, Michael Douglas, their board members and their celebrity that they're using that for. That fundamentally, the American Anti-Corruption Act was developed in 2013 by a former FEC chairman. Constitutional scholars swear by it. It's got ranked choice voting in there. It's got any gerrymandering. It's got congressional term limits, and then setting times where they can campaign and setting just boundaries with lobbying and things like that. And I may want to take lobbying a little further to see how much more, because ideas can be adopted for free. You know what I mean? Like if you look at the way things are set up now, staff and the revolving door and how they just get thrown in there and start appeasing, you know, lobbyist groups, the private sector. And it's just the laws to benefit them. The corporations are buying us out. That's my point when it comes to the media bias. Like they don't want a guy like me. I hope, you know, do you really need to push socioeconomic depression across the country on either CNN or Fox News, the big ones? Univision, I've been including a lot of this because there's a lot of Latinos here. I grew up watching my grandmother watch Univision. I can't speak Spanish myself. They wanted to promote, well, at least my aunt wanted to promote more English speaking. But I'm sure it's the same thing. You know what I mean? And the fundamental thing is that the corporation's not being held accountable. And if there's something like the American Capitalism Protection Act, that we got to go CEO salary caps. You know what I mean? Look at our sports. Look at our teams. I'm a Giants fan. I've been a Giants fan for a while. It's really cool that the New York Giants are celebrating their 100th season. And what is the other group that just from New York that's celebrating the 50th? Gosh, I can't remember what it was. It wasn't football. I can't remember what it's celebrating. Oh, Saturday Night Live. Saturday Night Live's having the 50th season. Love that show. It can get morbid and things like that. But yeah, you know what I mean? I wonder if some of the mainstream attention that I'm not getting. One of the independents running for local office, she was able to get soon as she in there, and I'm just waiting. You know what I mean? Maybe they're waiting for me to get on the ballot. The other two independents haven't heard anything. Why they haven't done that? And at the end of the day, if this thing falls apart, at the end of the day, a guy like
just ignored me or pissed on me, whatever it was. When this stuff starts getting bad, when it comes, if you don't, if people don't start spreading that, even if it's on social media, sharing a post or whatever, yeah, you know what I mean? I get a, you come at me, I'm gonna chew you out. You know what I mean? Consider it, Bruce, please. Just don't come at me like that. Come at me reasonably. You know what I mean? Ask me a question. Be decent about it. You know what I mean? I mean, in the patent world, whenever we respond to an office action, it's always when the attorneys do, it's respectfully. And to see this on paper, how attorneys go back and forth with examiners, you know, we're dealing with, you know, electronics, toys, fax, chemistry, things like, to see them go back and forth and then to, you know, dig a little deeper and find the, you know, the rules and the codes through the MPEP, the examiner manual, and just the procedure of the patent office and all that stuff. And to get, it gets a little complicated as you dig deep, as with most law is. And so, yeah, I hope to get some media attention here. I hope everyone knows that I'm in it for the right reasons and to bring everybody together, what of constitutional honesty. But that debate was crazy. You know what I mean? Biden won that debate. Now, you may say, well, he was slow. And yeah, okay. So short term, we preserve democracy with Joe Biden. And but that's no long-term goal. You know what I mean? He passes away, sure, Kamala gets in office, great. What is that? That's the same thing, maintaining the same status quo, assault weapon bans. We have the majority on these issues, or at least coming into this presidential election. You know what I mean? There was no red wave. You know what I mean? People are responding more so to Trump's unconstitutionality, and that's apparent even with the election, the previous election. So the previous general in 2022. So, you know what I mean? And that's kind of like the thing that people need to really look at. It's not just either or. Do you apply math in every day, going to the grocery store, how much time do you have until your next paycheck and how much is coming in and what can you buy, perishable items, et cetera, et cetera. Same thing, you know what I mean? Don't just look at it as two steps when it comes to voting for Joe Biden again, because it's the constitutional thing, but there's no long-term. A guy like me, we have to unseat the incumbent. That's why I need donations. I need donations to help do the groundwork. That's the stage two for me, is to get canvassers onto the ground and just passing out flyers, getting that name out there. If, you know, I can't rely on the media and things like that, you know what I mean? Then I need to rely on the people themselves. And that's a pure thing. That's a really cool thing. I've been feeling that my entire time. And sorry, my partner's distracting me. So anyways, and then just to be able to do that groundwork and get out there myself when I can find time. I have a day job, you know what I mean? So yeah, that's what it is backing up Joe Biden with my plan and then calling him out too. That's the thing about it. We want fiscal responsibility. Even those on the right, they know it. You don't always hear their voice. There's a silent majority here where both sides aren't being heard and they're just appeasing the 10% on each far end, and it's not working. We've got serious problems. And you know what I mean? Like I got on the train from work yesterday and I'm just sitting there and everyone's doing their best. You know, we're going home, but it's blazing hot outside. There's a heat wave. And this is like in my mind, like this is like a mild nuclear war with what we're going through. And, you know, we definitely need to sequester carbon. There's also carbon can also be recycled. There are things the oil industry can do to maintain their market share rather than just buy out the politics on it. And then just we all end up dying, and then they end up, the rich end up surviving, and then AI coming along. I could go on and on, you know what I mean? That's what my plan has done. Every item that is in my plan is looked at something objectively and brought a solution to it. So some things, if it's not broken, don't fix it. There's a lot of things broken, you know what I mean? It's not, I remember one guy had said that he didn't I've overheard him saying this to one of my canvassers just walking away from him, that they didn't want to do anything outside of the status quo because immediately they thought an independent is just going to mess things up and it just, it'd be a ruckus or a rebel. Well, I'm definitely a rebel, aren't we all? We're a country founded on rebels, okay? But is it for the right cause? Is it the right principle, right? And is it certainly peaceable too? You know what I mean? You can't, there's a lot of things out there where you can self-alienate yourself into thinking you're doing what's best for the country and it's not. So yeah, you know what I mean? And I'm not saying vote for, it's just a part of political science, I guess. Every time that I post something out there on social media, I have to tell myself, independent, oh yeah, I don't support Robert Kennedy Jr. every single time, because I've gotten a call from someone who thinks that I'm just, no, you got to really just look at it, just be open-minded. I said the same thing to my partner, just think differently, right? Just think differently, open-minded about this. That even if it's just psychological to run as an independent, leaning left to bring everybody together to hear those collective interests and just get it done and move on. That's it. You know what I mean? It's big. Look at the numbers. So really, I mean, Biden won that debate more so. If you could do a line, a line graph, where 0, minus 10, plus 10, Donald Trump's a minus 5, pretty much everything he said that came out of his mouth is a lie. Plus 2 for Joe Biden. The only thing that Donald Trump has on, or the right has on Joe Biden, he's just dropped the ball on the border. Everybody knows him. So what's the solution to that? Gross Domestic Product Protection Act, flip the switch with the fossil fuel assets and the green premium, delegate those resources from China to Mexico, and then immigrants aren't going to want to, people aren't going to want to come over here illegally. They'll have jobs here. We'll treat them the same as if they were workers, given sentence for the private sector. It's very simple shuffle. Very simple. So in a guy like Joe Biden, his false pride would get the best of him. You know what I mean? We all see that. You know what I mean? It's like, it's just, wow. I worked with this guy named Dick Apley. He worked at the patent office for about 40 years or something like that before he worked at the law firm that I worked at. I worked closely with him. Developing some new docketing strategies. They were having some problems, and he confirmed something for me. He was looking through this response from an examiner, and for 2 or 3 pages, it was just going on about the examiner's college degree. And Dick was super cool, super nice to work with. And he focused a lot on independent inventors at the patent office and a lot of that too at the firm. And he would say, you know, all it would have taken was like 3 or 4 sentences in a paragraph to do that. And you're just giving me your ego. You know what I mean? Just remove your ego and everything's going to run more smoothly. And it was really cool to hear that, to have that validation. I've been hearing that my whole life. You know what I mean? In a car crash, not cause a pile up. The ego is always going to be there. You would cross the street into traffic if you didn't have it. The ego can be good. Look at Michael Jordan. Look at the way they don't really allow so much the way that the game was played in the 90s as they do now, where they would just talk trash on the court, and you see him sticking his tongue out, you know what I mean, and just like dominating, psyching you out, and things like that, and not just psyching you out, just scoring and just winning, right? And then he tried to go to baseball. That didn't work so well, you know. So whatever. So that's the thing about it. You know what I mean? It's like the only reason why people probably like Donald Trump is because they just don't want to see us go socialist. I'm your guy to see for that. I'm not going to let, I'm not the only one. Abigail Spanberger, she's running for governor here in Virginia. And she has said that Biden had misunderstood his mandate. He didn't campaign a lot of the things that he was going on. And so she's purple. She's a purple candidate. I see that. That's cool. And even Liz Cheney has helped out with some of that with her. I remember going into Yesley Bake. She was running against Abigail Spanberger was running against Yesley Vega, and Liz Cheney ended up helping her out later. But just the way that people look at things is everything's, a lot of the times people think backwards and everything like that. So Liz Cheney helped, because just who Yesley Vega was, she believed in the election denial and all this stuff. So yeah, really look at it, this game about politics, just like anywhere else. It's principles over personalities. It's very easy to get caught up with whoever's on that screen who can just like look like they know what they're talking about or whatever. Oh, Vivek Ramaswamy, he's one of the worst at it. He looks like he knows what he's talking about. He throws a bunch of word salad in there. And you think, wow, that guy, even his business fundamentally on that patent of that medication was for Alzheimer's, or was it Parkinson's? It was Alzheimer's, wasn't it? One of the two, and he put that out there, and it was bunk, and he knew it. He would rather have risked people that had invested in that than the people that boosted him up in that circle of Wall Street to initially put up the money for that and then just manipulate everybody else. He's going to do that with everything. You can tell, your gut tells you that when he talks about anything. It's just, anyways. So that's pretty much, people will say whatever they want about the presidential debate. Biden bombed. Yeah, he did. I mean, he had a bad day, sure. Behind the scenes, he's still holding up true to those left policies. But long term, again, when it's just the way that he's known to F things up. Obama said that in 2020, if it's come to the border or if it's come to climate change or whatever like that. You know what I mean? Like I said, it goes back to that line graph. Plus 2. It could be at a plus 7, a plus 8. You know what I mean? But with him in there, and it's just, So, got about 6 minutes left to, I really need donations. You know what I mean? That's something, if it's just $10, $15, you can go to my website. There's a little button
That's right. It's on the right. It's never been my foremost thing to ever be about the donations. That's like the first red flag that I see for any politician. First thing, especially how money's corrupted everything, to see that. And I've been playing that honest game where it's like, I don't. Am I sharing my screen at all? Where I don't ask for donations, but if I don't ask for donations, I'm not going to be able to hire the canvassers to do the ground game while I'm doing my day job. It's essentially just paying for their jobs and having them on the ground promoting. And so if you see this little thing right here, you see that donate. I don't go, you're not going to see Act Blue on there. You're not going to see Win Red. This is a this little form here is from Donor Box. You know what I mean? And that all money gets disclosed and things like that. This again, if you have a problem with my initial compromising idea of rescinding bans of firearms, certain firearms, assault weapons, and the abortion ban, then let's talk about it. Why not? And again, I've said this to my girlfriend, and she didn't have an argument or response. You know what I mean? In the cities, you know what I mean? Like that hasn't been a big of a problem as it has in red states. So I definitely like. Firearms maybe has to be in a special case, you know what I mean? Like limit. Why would you need any ammunition for that if you're just doing it for sport? You know what I mean? Or maybe the military and whatever is different. But if you're, there's no reason to discharge that here if you're gonna go out of town or whatever, buy the ammo there. It's like maybe set up a limit, a boundary for that if you want still want to. But to completely it's a ban assault weapon. Same thing with abortion. You have to draw a line at least. Where read the pro-choice here. Read that. Don't just get stuck on any term. Absorb the whole thing. If you have a question, ask it. I will be more than happy to explain that if that's off of social media or on social media. This show doesn't really have. It's not. It's paid for media. No, this is. Yeah. So I'm in complete control of this. But that doesn't mean that I wouldn't want to hear what. Majority, like, why wouldn't these compromising ideas work? Would you rather just stay the status quo? Okay. So, yeah, you know what I mean? I'm going to stick with Biden. I don't like it. You know what I mean? And I only feel better about that because if I get elected, I can bring those ideas forward. I can really improve these numbers. This doesn't, I talk about this sometimes and it might come off as being arrogant or too confident or whatever it is. These aren't my, this isn't, it was like Dave Chappelle said when he got up there on, one of his comedy shows, he realized that his dream that he, I haven't been pursuing politics my whole life, I'm more of an inventor, but he found out that his dream was actually everybody else's. I mean, that's kind of where I feel like these items that I've adopted or formulated myself, that this stuff has been going on way before I even got involved in the politics. You know, I mean, that's 13 years old. This is mine, but it borrows work from Robert Reich and all their collective ideas. Going back to the CEO salary caps and just all about finding the right ratio. Won't hinder progress. You know what I mean? We can. There's things that we can do. Let's talk about rather than just letting the corporations buy us out from every angle. That's what they're doing in other countries. I'm sure they see that too, and it's connected. It's international finance involved with that. So yeah, I mean that's pretty much all I had to talk about today. The one thing that the media didn't cover was the. Primary was canceled here for the VA 08 House, and I think it's because guys like me didn't run in the Democratic Party. This gives me more time as an independent to get to be known. Otherwise, it would have been very easy to get blacklisted.